Welcome to Factorio Masterclass. My name is Nilaus, and this is the series of tutorials and guides here on YouTube covering all aspects of the game and aims to provide insights and resources to help you improve. We've been covering many of the parts of the early game, mid game, the late game, but what we are now starting to work on, starting with the previous one on beacon smelting, is now we're getting into the ultra late game, the very late game builds where beacons, modules, and maximum production are at the core. And we're going to start with looking at the thing that you're going to need the most of, and that's electronic circuits. So that's what we're going to do today. Now, each of these masterclass videos usually starts as a workshop session streamed live on my Twitch channel. This is over at twitch.tv/Nilaus, and you're very welcome to drop by. I'm streaming live on Twitch 6 nights a week, except Saturday, and it's at 8 p.m. Central European time. If you want to hang out, if you want to join, see the games, we're playing mainly Factorio, but also other games, then do feel free to drop by. Maybe you watched some of my previous masterclass videos, maybe you have not. If you haven't, do check them out. If you have, well, if you like it, then hit the like button. And if you want to see more of the content like this, then hit the subscribe button to subscribe for more content like this here on the channel. If you have ideas, comments, or feedback, then leave a comment below or join the Discord server or join the live streams everywhere. I'm reading all of it and I respond to most of it. So let's dive into the design. Here we are with the design, and the objective is to make some green circuits. Green circuits are, or electronic circuits, I'm going to call them green circuits, but the recipe is simple. The trick here is that since we're making it in the endgame scenario, then we are going to make fully modules, and not just that, but we are also going to fully module this part. So here we have just the core ingredients we need. We need copper going into copper coils, going into the electronic circuits, and that's what we want to do. So when we are talking about endgame builds, there are a few parameters that are essential. And one of them is that you want to design things around full blue belts so that you have something that's compressed going in and compressed going out. So you have as few partial belts as possible. This has several different reasons. First of all, it is the maximum capacity you can get out of it. So if you are designing for a full belt, then you know that you are not wasting any capacity. If you're building something for half belt, then you're going to end up having twice as many belts as you need. So when possible, design for full belts. The second thing is that as you reach really into the late game and your PC is starting to, or your server is starting to slow down, it's actually optimal to have fewer full belts instead of more partial belts. So design towards full belts. It also gives you a much better comprehension of what the capacity is or what the production is. If you look at four full lines of green circuits, then you know that's 180 per second. So this is what we're going to do as a design criteria. Now the thing is, if we look at this, I'm going to use the two key mods. One is Max Rate Calculator. This is the one I'm using now. You can drag over it and you can see some key ingredients here. Basically what you see here is this is the output of all the machines. So this one is outputting 2.8 per second. And we're seeing this up here, the electronic circuit is consuming 3 inbounds. So already at this point, we have a problem. We can't just make it 1-to-1 because this is only producing 2.8. And if I make them like this, then I'm not getting enough. This one will be starved. And if it's starved, that means I don't utilize the full potential of this one. And that's really disadvantageous. Now, as we are designing this, we are going to need some beacons. You will always need beacons. So let's build the beacon design. I'll just make a row like this. And there. So this is our premise. Like that. So now we are going to see a different speed. We are going to take, again, Max Rate Calculator. And now we still have the same issue. Obviously, we still have the same issue. It's just scaled up to a much higher degree. So our objective now is to make sure that this ratio, the outbound copper coils, is matching the inbound copper coils. Because if we have 15.4 from one machine, that would actually be really beneficial, because that means we can take three of these configurations, and three configurations would give us slightly more than the 45 capacity of a belt. So this is going to be our design criteria. So what we could do, and what we are going to do, is, what if we built an extra one here? Now let's do that again. Now we have a slight overproduction of copper coils going into here. So we're producing 34.3 per second and we're consuming 33 per second. So that's a bit of a surplus. That means we can keep this electronic circuit assembler going all the time. So I'm happy about this. Real happy, actually. Can we do more like this? Well, we could actually do it the other way around. So this one is also available. That's good. And could we do one more? Well, maybe we can do it that way, I guess. So at this point, if we just... Okay, well, we'll deal with the power later on, will we? I'll just... And this is the second interesting mod that I'm using for these designs. That is called Editor Extended. It has these capabilities to make infinite resources and destroy infinite resources, which is really handy when you're just doing test setups like this. So let's have a look. If we look at each pair, they are going to be exactly the same. The reason why it's important to look at the pairs is because these are going to be direct insertion, and therefore if this one's overproducing and this one underproducing, that's not going to help us, even if the total looks correct. And the total amount is, we're going to consume 34 and 36.75. We're going to have a slight overproduction of copper coils, which means that we will be able to saturate, and I have 46.2 up here. That's pretty good. If I take one of these out, it's going to decrease, but even just taking one beacon out, it's going to drop it below the 45. So we can't limit it more than this. Now that was the first part of a design like this. This is always how I start. I always start by just figuring out how many machines do I need and what could be a potential configuration. From here, the next task will be figuring out if we can actually service it with belts. And well, we are going to say, like, we have quite conveniently, we can take things in on these locations. This is where I use the mod. And copper in over on this side, iron in and iron in there. So we have those, and just at the core, we could just take this all the way up there. So far, so good. Now there comes the next constraint, and that is input. These are going to need two inserts, because this in and of itself is consuming 12.25. The one of these inserters cannot handle 12.25. When it picks up from a belt, then it's about 11 to 13. So I'm not going to count on it. I'm going to put two inserters in here. This definitely needs two inserters. And this one also needs two inserters. We can just see how much this is, 11. If I do it only one, then when I get further up on the belt, and if the belt is not always full, then it can't support. So I'm going to go add a bit more here than I might need. So this is the first one. Now we just need an output. What I'd like to do is the output is, I would like to, this one to be put on one side, this one to put on the other side. And then the last one, which has sort of more room, is sort of putting it on a balance on either side. I think that's going to be the right way to do it. So what I could do and will do is take this thing, put it out here. That's going to put it on the inside, and then we'll just casually take this out. Because if I build it here, this one can very, very conveniently build it on the other side. And I can then take it up like this. And maybe we should also, while we're at it, take a look at power poles. So there could be a power pole here, which will cover all of it. And then the other power pole could be here. That means there's an optimal distance of power poles between them. That's good. And we can now take from this location and move up like so. Get up here. And we're going to need to mirror this one. So two inbound. This one continues to jump up. How far can you jump? Don't really want you to jump that far up, because we're going to have the next one. Input. There. And here. All right. This one seems to be working. And naturally. We'll put a few lights. Those locations seem to be the perfect places for lights. And now we have this one. This one will also need two inserters outbound. And the way I want to do this is do it this way. And what we can do is up here, we can simply start taking things out. Let's have a look and see if things are working. This one's not working because it doesn't have the two inbounds here. So what I'm doing is I'm taking the 15 on one side plus 15 on the other side. And then each side of this has capacity for 22.5. And this one will be putting out another 15, but it needs to put half in on either side. Now this way of doing it is actually, well, you know, it doesn't actually need to be this close. It can just be here. I need to make sure that there's a tiny buffer on the belt, as you can see here, because every time this swings, this will move. And it's very important. Well, if you design it, it's probably a good idea to design it so that there are no gaps here. And this is basically very, very simple how you do it. Now, the actual demands of this is slightly less than what you do in, if we take the theoretical max. So it's going to be 33 plus 36. It's more likely going to be 32 and, I don't know, 34, I guess, because of the capacity here. I've calculated that, and it's in the blueprint as well. The brilliant thing about this one, or the best thing I think about this one, is that when you build it, it tiles really well. So you can just do, if you do something like this, then in a very limited space, which is pretty much quadratic, you've now gotten four belts of each inbound, four belts, and then four belts fully outbound here. Doesn't take much space, takes a lot of power and a lot of capacity, but at the end of the day, that's not really a big concern. Something that some people might be concerned about is like the fact that I'm consuming mainly from one side. If you really have a big issue with it, you can change it yourself, but I don't think that's a problem. I'll do that by basically having a... So you can see here, one belt is moving a lot faster than the other belt. What you can do is you can simply make a lane balancer if you don't want to have this unevenly consumed. Okay, that's going to have to be there. So if you have something like this, then you will make sure that whatever comes in, I can actually move this way out. There. You'll now see that both of these lines will be moving at the same speed, despite the fact that on the outside lane, the inner lane is going to consume way more. But with these small balancers, everything is fine. If you don't like it, don't put them in. I've not put them into the blueprint. But if you're, for example, unloading a train, and then you need to make sure that it gets unloaded appropriately. And you have now 180 green circuits per second. Pretty simple. I have similar builds for red circuits and blue circuits, but I will take those in separate videos because I'd like to go into just this detail of explaining how I build it. And then you can watch it, and if you need to build it, you don't have to sort of scrub through the video for whichever build it is, but you have one video for late game green circuit builds. And this is more, one of the other things about it is that I'm taking inputs on one side, outputs on the other side. In my normal builds, the bus builds, I take inputs and outputs on the same side because I wanted to go back on the bus. That's not how we design things here. Here we take things in and then we take it on the other side. For example, we have trains here and then we have to pick up trains here for the green circuits. That's how I more imagine this kind of late game builds. And that is really the core of it. So I did not even have a time to take a little break to thank all the patrons who are supporting the channel. So I'll just do that now. Thank you very much, all the patrons, to supporting the channel. This is really what makes it possible for me to do these kind of videos and do it so regularly, because it does take a lot of time on research, setup, recording, editing, all that stuff to put these together. And that's really because of the patronage of the community that I'm able to do that without having channel sponsors. So thank you very much to all the patrons. If you want to support the channel, there's no obligation, of course. There is a link in the description below to the Patreon, and I really appreciate it. Thank you very much. And As I mentioned before, if you like it, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel for more content like this. If you want to hang out live and or have something to share and just want to see us build in a live context, then I'm streaming live on Twitch. As I mentioned, this is at twitch.tv/Nilaus, also link in the description below. 6 nights a week, 8 p.m. Central European time, Factorio and other games. I hope to see you either here on YouTube, on Discord server, on Twitter, or on Twitch. Thank you for watching, and as always, stay effective.